We have an email question to start us off tonight. This one is from Leslie. I was injured and haven't gone to the ER or gotten any medical treatment because I don't want to catch coronavirus. What should I tell my insurance? Should I still call a lawyer? Great question.
Leslie, the answer is yes, yes, and yes. First thing is, I don't know the nature of your injury exactly and what happened, but you if it happened on the job, you need to report it to your employer. Your employer has something called workers' compensation, and there's a time frame, very tight time frame, where your employer has to report it to the insurance carrier if it occurs at work. If there's somebody else that might be responsible, for instance, if it's an automobile accident, you're on a tight time frame for the PIP insurance, the no-fault insurance that we have here in the state of Florida. You know, back in the 1970s, we started this out where it's $10,000, but then just a few years back, the legislature decided to say, hey, guess what? You have to seek medical treatment within the first 14 days of the onset or from the accident in order to receive the full personal injury protection benefits, and it has to be classified as an emergency medical condition. I gave a post on Facebook about this, about going to the emergency room. If you are injured or if you are hurt, if you feel like you need to go to the emergency room, then you should do so. It is safe to go to the emergency rooms here in our areas. If you have coronavirus, or you think that you have the flu, or you have the coronavirus type symptoms, call ahead and stop the spread. That's to your doctor's office, that's to any medical facility. If you feel like you've got the coronavirus, call ahead. They will segregate you and put you in and do a separate intake for you in a quarantined, isolated type area. You don't want to just show up coughing up a lung, hacking up a lung at the emergency room, of course, unless you have to. But where possible, call ahead. Make sure, even if you have to call an ambulance, tell the dispatch operator that you feel like that you may have flu-like symptoms so that they can be prepared when they arrive. But otherwise, if you're injured and you're hurt, it is safe to go to the emergency room. It is safe to go to those doctor's offices, which are open. Also available to you typically is telemedicine. If you have health insurance, again, I use the example of Blue Cross Blue Shield because they have 70% of the market share. They have telemedicine available throughout whatever plan that you have. It doesn't matter if it's the bronze plan, to the gold, to the platinum plan, to the silver plan, whatever it is, telemedicine is available. And right now, Blue Cross Blue Shield is offering telemedicine for free. So there's lots of different options for you to seek medical treatment, to seek medical attention. If you're hurt and you're still got a worry about whether or not you need medical attention, odds are you probably do. You're probably talking to your significant other, you're probably talking to your children, you're probably talking to your dog saying, hey, I hurt, I can't walk you. If there's something interfering with your life, then you need to go seek medical attention. Lots of different options to do that.
And Larry, just to clarify, I know you did say this right at the beginning, but you have 14 days, right, to go if you do need emergency treatment, 14 days to go do that before you can't make a claim on it?
That is for an automobile accident case, okay. Courtney. And so you can make a claim for it. It doesn't change that. But the opening up the personal injury protection or the no-fault benefits, there's two things that have to take place. Leslie would have to seek medical treatment within the first 14 days. And the medical provider, whoever she seeks, is going to have to kind of check off the box to say, yes, you needed this treatment as it related to the accident, and it is an emergency medical condition. It's a made-up diagnostic code by the Florida legislature. It doesn't meet with any, you know, as far as real treatment plans are concerned. It is merely something to check off for the insurance companies in order to do that. Going back to workers' compensation, if it occurred on the job, it's supposed to be reported within 24 hours, and then the employer is supposed to report it again within 48 hours to the workers' compensation carrier. If it goes on and lingers on, it puts the coverages at issue, meaning you may not have workers' compensation coverage. So at best, or at the very least, what you should do is report it to your employer. Do it by email, do it by something that you can, I injured myself doing this on such and such a date. It didn't get well over the weekend, and I'm reporting it to you now. You need to make sure that you do that. Put it somewhere where it's timed and date stamped so that you've protected yourself, and it's something for your employer to work from as well.